In this learning module, we will take a high-level look at Spotfire expressions. Whether you intend to create new expressions or modify existing expressions, a basic understanding of the Spotfire expression language gives you the power to manipulate aspects of your analysis which, otherwise, cannot be configured using the graphical user interface controls which are presented within the application. The first thing you should know is that Spotfire handles the data you have imported in order to represent it visually. For example, the height of a bar in a bar chart may reflect multiple values from the underlying data table, and you may elect to represent that bar height as the sum of those values, the average of those values, or a wide variety of other aggregation options, any of which requires some mathematical manipulation or data handling. In other words, an expression is used to aggregate data. These aggregate values may represent not only bar height, but also marker position, item size, line position, cross table value, color, pie sector size, icon rule threshold, shape, etc., etc., etc. Knowing that these expressions exist and learning how to create and edit them to suit your own needs will greatly expand your analytical capabilities in TIBCO Spotfire. Expressions may be constructed in order to generate new columns in the data table, and a new column is also a new filter and a new option to select for visualization axes, color, trellis, and a host of other visualization properties. The same expression language which is used to generate calculated columns is applied to aggregate data in visualizations in order to represent visual items such as bar height, marker position, size, color, etc. And you can edit these visualization expressions to suit your own needs. These custom expressions will modify the way in which visual items are presented and can substantially extend your analytical capabilities beyond those which can be accomplished by interacting with the graphical user interface selectors alone. Let's take a quick look at an example where both a calculated column and a custom expression have been applied in a Spotfire analysis. Use Open File and navigate to the example with Expressions Overview in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. This is a view of the original underlying data table of values, imported from our data source containing Megamart customer purchase values. On the next tab, this table visualization shows two of those imported columns, total amount of purchases and number of items purchased. A calculated column was inserted using this dialog, which employed this expression in order to determine the customer's average item purchase price for each row. The calculated column was then applied to the value axis of this bar chart, where we can see that rural customers tend to purchase, on average, slightly higher priced items than do suburban and urban customers. We can achieve the same analytical goal by adding an expression directly to the value axis of the bar chart. If we open the value axis property selector and toggle into expanded mode, you can see the expression displayed here. An alternative dialog for constructing or editing a custom expression on a visualization has the same general layout as the calculated columns dialog and provides a more robust user interface for including elements in the expression like columns, properties, and functions. One of the more challenging constructs in expressions for Spotfire users to understand is the overstatement. Simply put, the over keyword is applied to construct expressions which redirect the way in which Spotfire would otherwise group data for aggregation. And while it is generally applied differently, these overstatements can be extremely useful in both calculated columns and custom expressions. In calculated columns, the overstatement is generally applied in order to group data going down a column based upon categorical values in the data table, while over in custom expressions is more frequently used to redirect calculations to other areas of a hierarchy. Node navigation functions indicate specific areas of a hierarchy, while axis.name values indicate which property on a visualization is displaying that hierarchy. Let's take a look at a couple of examples where the over keyword has been applied in expressions by returning to our demonstration in progress. On the tab titled Over, this table has been configured to show the imported columns, store number, and electronics. A third column is the result of inserting a calculated column, which includes an overstatement. The expression used to generate that calculated column can be interpreted as the average electronics purchase amount made in each store number. If we click to sort the table based upon store number, you can see that the average value, which is calculated for each store, is repeated on each row where that store number identifier appears. Thus, this value represents the average of these four numbers, and clicking to sort in descending order, this value represents the average of these three purchase amounts. The application of the over keyword in a custom expression usually includes a node navigation element. For example, here you can see a bar chart which displays the total furniture purchase amount per quarter. The expression which generates the value for the height of each bar is quite straightforward. However, this bar chart uses a more complex expression in order to take each quarterly sum of furniture purchases and subtract from it the sum of furniture purchases made in the previous quarter. So you can see how the over keyword was applied in order to redirect the calculation to use the previous value along the x-axis. While this was accomplished with a custom expression, we didn't have to customize an expression for this particular analytical goal because there are several commonly used expressions which you do not have to build from scratch. These are known as expression shortcuts, and they are made available on the selectors of suitably configured visualization properties. The expressions which result from the selection of these aggregation options may be applied without any knowledge of how they accomplish the intended result. However, they represent good examples of expression syntax and might be considered as a useful starting point for learning the Spotfire expression language and creating your own custom expressions. One example of Spotfire expression syntax, which is used frequently within these expression shortcuts, is the application of then-value keywords in order to process an expression in stages, which is particularly useful when working with in-database data. And again, these expression shortcuts provide more examples of overstatements in action, including some very useful node navigation functions. Let's return to our demonstration in order to get a peek of a couple of these expression shortcuts applied to visualizations. On the tab titled Expression Shortcuts, this bar chart displays the total garden purchase amount for each quarter, while this bar chart uses an expression shortcut to calculate the difference year over year for those garden purchases. In other words, the expression instructs the visualization to redirect its calculations in order to subtract each quarter's value from that of the same quarter in the previous year. You can see that because there was no previous year for the data collected in 2013, no bars are displayed. However, if you compare the original bars for each quarter in 2013 to the corresponding quarter in 2014, you can see the result of that difference calculation displayed in the height of these bars. This bar chart has been configured to use a percent of total expression shortcut. Therefore, each of these bar lengths reflect the percentage of grocery purchases over all locations and settings. Consequently, the sum of all these percentages is 100%, or the total. While the examples employed thus far have used simple functions like sums and averages, values can be handled within expressions using a variety of functions. Somewhere in the neighborhood of 200 functions are available for use within the Spotfire expression language. Therefore, these functions are organized into categories, making it easier to locate the function of interest from the broad array of data handling capabilities which are available. As you begin to work with functions in expressions, you should be made aware that the columns, properties, numbers, and text values which are entered into expressions as variables are referred to as arguments, and those arguments usually, though not always, follow the function within parentheses and are separated by commas. Let's take a very quick look at just a few examples of commonly used functions. On the tab titled Functions, you can see that the imported columns, store number identifier, and purchase values in the toys department are handled to generate five different calculated columns. The first applies a rank function, where the first argument is the column of values to be ranked, and the second argument is the categorical grouping over which the ranking should occur. The table has been sorted to organize each of the stores together and order the rows within each store based upon the rank assignment. The next expression applies an if statement. The first argument tests the condition of the value in the toys column. If it is greater than 100, the second argument is returned. If it is not greater than 100, the third argument is returned. So you can see the two potential results displayed in this column. Let's assume that we have string data, like this, which we wish to simplify. The next calculated column applies a left function in order to keep only the first five characters of that string. Another text handling function is applied in the next calculated column in order to represent all characters as uppercase. And the final column calculates the maximum toy purchase amount from each store by applying an over function. While much of the data which you will handle within the Spotfire analysis environment exists within the underlying data tables, values may also exist in the analysis document as properties. These may be stored as document properties, column properties, or data table properties. And you can configure property controls in text areas which are used to enter and edit these property values. Once defined and collected, the property value may be included as a variable within an expression. Thus, interacting with the property controls to change the property values will change the results of calculated columns or custom expressions. Let's revisit our demonstration example one more time. On the tab titled Property Controls, you can see that a text area has been configured with two property controls. One collects a regional store location value, and the other collects a numerical discount to apply. The table visualization shows the two imported columns, store location and shoe purchase amounts. And a calculated column has been inserted using this expression to handle those imported values and the values stored as document properties, in order to display the row-by-row impact of the discount on shoe purchase amounts. For example, you can see the impact of the 10% discount which has been applied to only Los Angeles store locations. If we change the store location drop-down list to Seattle or Boston, you can see how the results of the calculated column adjust accordingly. We can also use this slider in order to change the amount of discount which is applied, and watch the corresponding values adjust in the calculated column. And don't forget that this dynamic column could be used to support visualizations, or that custom expressions may be similarly configured to include property values which may be adjusted through property controls positioned within text areas, resulting in an interactive and dynamic analysis environment. As you begin the process of editing or creating your own expressions, bear in mind that Spotfire includes expression-building helpers which present themselves when you are working within the various expression dialogues. Different components within an expression will be colored differently, and shading will occur to indicate open and close parentheses which match. You can separate an expression onto multiple lines in order to make it easier to read without any impact on the result. And as you type, watch for intelligent pop-up dialogues which will attempt to determine if you are typing a function, column name, or property, and give you options to complete what you have started. Finally, an exclamation point alert will indicate that there is an error somewhere within your syntax, and may even provide some useful hints for correcting that error when you mouse over the alert icon.